The Pretzel board is a low-cost yet powerful IoT Wi-Fi board, offering a versatile learning and teaching platform. It nicely combines an Arduino Nano and an ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. This freely programmable development board is easy to use, for example, to control your lights at home, your Lego robots, and many other wireless projects. The Arduino IDE provides the simplest way of programming the board. As you start, you have to choose the correct port and board. Select Arduino Nano. As an example, let's show how easy it is to use a Pretzel board in your wireless home network to control an LED from your smartphone with a button on a web page. The code mainly consists of 8 commands sent on the Pretzel board by the Arduino Nano to the Wi-Fi module. The full listing of this example code is available here. You just need to download the code, modify the network name and your password, and upload the code to the Arduino Nano on the Pretzel board via the USB connection. Open the serial monitor on your PC and set the transfer rate to 19,200 baud. Once the Wi-Fi module connects to your wireless home network, it starts sending data to the Arduino Nano. These data are also sent by the Nano on the USB connection to the serial port. This is how we find the IP address of our Pretzel board. Connect your smartphone to the same network as the Pretzel board. Enter this IP as URL in your browser on your smartphone. Our webpage with the button shows up. Note, your phone has to be connected. Now let's see how the program is built. The included software serial library is used for the serial communication on the Pretzel board between Arduino Nano and the Wi-Fi module. Some variables are defined. SSID is the name of your local network. The webpage is stored in the variable webpage and the status of the LED is stored in LED status. The LED is connected to pin 2 of the board and is called Ready LED in this program. Here, the serial connection is made with the integrated Wi-Fi module. The webpage.reserve function makes sure there is enough memory to store your webpage. The LED shows that the board is connected and ready to use. Then, the connect Wi-Fi function is called. It configures the board to connect to your network and turns the LED on. The connect Wi-Fi function sends the AT commands to the Wi-Fi module. The second parameter of the function is the timeout time. The function waits this long for a response. The most important AT command is the third one. This command tells the Wi-Fi module to which network it has to connect. In the main loop, we wait for an incoming connection from a web page. The web page sends the HTTP request. This request is stored in the first part of the loop. An HTTP request looks like this. For this program, only the first line is important. The second half of the loop function checks if the request starts with this. If it does, the Wi-Fi module received a valid request. Then the connection ID is extracted from the request. This is located here. Then the following simple web page is sent, consisting of a single button. When this button is pressed, a new HTTP request is sent by the browser on the smartphone, with some information that the button is pressed. In this case, this information is the word LED added to the request. Once the web page is sent, the connection is closed. The program then searches the HTTP request for the word LED. If this is present, the LED will be toggled on or off. This is how the AT commands and the web page are sent to the Wi-Fi module. After the specified time for the module to respond, its answer is sent to the serial monitor so you can see what the module has to say. Before sending the web page, we specifically need to inform the browser on your smartphone about how many bytes it's going to receive. Thank you for watching and don't forget to link, like or subscribe to our channel. Bye bye!